Hi guys. Hi, Teresa Love here. So I have another word from the Lord. He's so good. And I'm so excited to release this word. I'm really excited about today because I just came from an event and I got to pray with a grandmother and it was so powerful. It was like in the restroom after the event was over, everybody was really gone. And then it was just us and she just opened her heart. And you know, the event, I actually didn't have to be at the event. It was for CE, but I had already had my CE, but I was just like, well, you know, what the heck, you know, I'll just get it in a rollover and everything. And I just love how God works. You know, you just never know. You just have to be ready in and out of season, you know, and I'm so excited. It just blessed my heart to come alongside her and pray for a little girl. It was, I think she said her pastor or her pastor's son's daughter, 3, and was diagnosed with cancer. And she had just found out about it and that they were going to have surgery tomorrow. But the thing is that she just recently lost her 4-year-old granddaughter. And, you know, I was just like, okay, when you wash your hands, we're going to pray. And I had holy oil in my bag. And I was like, she was like, that's good. I'm like, I don't go anywhere without my holy oil. And we prayed and God met us there. Oh, he met us there so mightily. I can't wait for the testimony. I know God shifted things. I know God uses us. And she was like, you're powerful. Like, no, it's not me. It's the presence of God. And I was just so excited. And oh, I'm overjoyed of God's goodness. We just never know. We just never know. And yeah, just ready in and out of season because God is moving. But when I was praying yesterday for a dear friend and his dad and just praying, you know, for myself and things like that, I heard the scripture of where Jonathan, you know, his armor bearer, which is actually Samuel 14:6-7. And I'm going to read it here. It says, and Jonathan said to the young man that bare his armor, come and let us go over unto the garrisons of these uncircumcised. It may be that the Lord will work for us, for there is no restraint to the Lord to save by many or by few. Remember that, by many or by few. And the armor bearer said unto him, do all that is thy heart. Turn thee, behold, I am with thee according to thy heart. And I was just like, hallelujah, Jesus. God is saying in this very moment, you don't have to have a many people on your side, on your team, as he aligns you. God is going to save. God is going to do what he does by few. God is, according to our heart, God is going to bring our promises and our blessings to us. And this is, as I meditated, this is what God poured into my heart. God is partnering individuals for kingdom purposes. He's aligning members, sons and daughters, of his body to flow unhindered in this season. For the Lord is orchestrating his divine will. The Lord is orchestrating his divine will. We must recognize the time and the season for which we are in. You must position your heart for the promise, guys. We must position. Remember the scripture said, do what according to your heart. For it was already recognized within Jonathan's spirit that the Lord will give over the uncircumcised. So those of us that are in our promised land, you know where you are with the Lord. Those of us that are in our promised land, those have been waiting, walking in obedience. The remnant. God is saying now, he is ready again to deliver. The battle is the Lord. So we're in a promised land. We're walking and God is going to deliver those giants for us. According to our heart, according to what we believe to be true. We must have a fleshy heart, meaning an open, a teachable heart, heart willing to trust the will of the Lord and walk in obedience to his will. Many are being asked to walk on water. Many are being asked to walk by faith. Yes, even after disappointments, even after delays, or after betrayals from ministries, churches, people we love, through leadership, we are being asked to walk by faith right now. Walk on water. But the Lord quickened. Remember, Peter actually walked on the water until he took his eyes off Jesus. Yes, the Lord still saved him and provided for him, equipped him, and allowed him to build his church through him. So we can't mess it up. We can't miss it. God is with us. God is aligning those that's supposed to be with us. I wrote, the Lord is doing a new thing, and we must continue to prepare and get into position. You do not have to have many with you to accomplish your purpose. God has spoken. He will do it for you and I. You will not have to fight alone anymore. You will not have to fight. Those of you that have felt that the Lord had forsaken you or anything, he was always there. But he moved you. He moved those people out of your life. He rearranged things for a time such as this. And I'm so excited, like I said. God is partnering individuals for kingdom purposes. He is aligning members again, his sons and daughters of his body, to flow unhindered in this season. For the Lord is orchestrating his divine will for us. I'm so excited. I'm so overjoyed. God is for us. If God be for us, who can be against us? Stand in faith. Walk on water. Allow your heart to be healed. Because again, according to that heart, your promise will be delivered. So let's pray. Father, I thank you for this word. I thank you that you're moving, and you're moving mightily, God. As we trust, as we listen, as we wait, as we pray, as we fast, as we walk in obedience, may thy will be done, Father, in and through our lives, in and through your sons and daughters' lives. May you have mercy, Father, as you usher us into victory. Oh, I feel so much joy, God. I feel so much joy. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for everything, God. Thank you. Thank you for my brothers and sisters. Thank you for their destinies. Thank you for the open doors that's swinging wide open. In Jesus' name, be glorified, my King. Be glorified. We love you. We love you. We love you. Amen. Amen. So, again, Teresa Love with a word from the Lord. I hope it blessed you, and I can't wait to see you soon. Amen. Amen.